Assalamu alaikum friends, welcome to this MATLAB tutorial. Today I am going to teach you how to design boost converter in MATLAB Simulink software. Friends, we know that a boost converter is a DC to DC converter with an output voltage greater than the source voltage or input voltage as shown here in this animated figure. Due to this reason, a boost converter is sometimes called a step-up converter, since it steps up the source voltage. The power for the boost converter can come from any suitable DC source such as batteries, solar panels, rectifiers, and DC generators. Since power P is equal to VI must be conserved, therefore, the output current is lower than the source current in order to maintain the total power. There are several methods by which output DC voltage can be increased. Number 1, by connecting batteries in series, the output voltage can be increased. Number 2, by using inverter, transformer, and rectifier combination, the output DC voltage can also be increased. Number 3, by using boost converter, the output DC voltage can also be increased. Let's discuss the first method. Suppose we have a battery having voltage of 12 volt and we want to increase its voltage up to 24 volt. Then two batteries of 12 volt can be connected in series to get the 24 volt output DC voltage. It means that battery power system often stacks cells in series to achieve higher voltages. However, sufficient stacking of cell is not possible in many high voltage applications due to the lack of space. Let's discuss the second method of increasing the output DC voltage. Suppose we have DC voltage of 12 volt. Now we want to increase this voltage to DC voltage of 24 volt. This can be obtained by first converting this 12 volt DC voltage into AC voltage by using the inverter. Now this 12 volt AC voltage can be step up to 24 volt AC by using the step up transformer. Now this 24 volt AC voltage can be converted into 24 volt DC voltage by using the rectifier. By this way, the output DC voltage can be increased. However, this method has the disadvantages that it is very bulky, inefficient, and very costly. To overcome these issues, the output DC voltage can be increased by using the boost converter method. Boost converter method has the advantages that it is very efficient, having efficiency higher than 90%. Furthermore, it is very cheap and lightweighted. Consider the figure which shows the circuit diagram of the boost converter. It may be noted that the boost converter may consist of at least two semiconductors, a diode and a transistor, and at least one energy storage element such as capacitor or inductor or the both two in combination. Let's design this boost converter in MATLAB Simulink software. For this purpose, double click on this Simulink icon to open it. In this window, click on this icon to open a new model. First, we need to save it. You may save it with any name of your choice and in any folder. Look at the figure. To design the boost converter, first we need the DC battery voltage source. To get this, go to Simulink library and go to SimScape, then click on Power System, then click on Specialized Technology, then click on Fundamental Blocks, then click on Electrical Sources. You can see DC voltage source block is available here. Right click on this block and click on Add Block to the model. It will appear in the model. Now double click on this block to put the value. We know that according to the data, the input source voltage is 12 volt. Therefore, come to model and put here 12 volt and press OK. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that now we need to connect the inductor block. Therefore, come to model again. Take this 3-phase series RLC branch from here and bring it in the model. Connect positive terminal with the positive terminal of DC voltage source. As we need inductor, therefore double click on this block. In the branch type, select inductor and press OK. We know that according to data, the value for inductor is 76.8 microhenry. Therefore, come to model and put here 76.8 microhenry value and press OK. Friends, these values are calculated mathematically for this specific system. I will make another video very soon on how to calculate different parameters of the boost converter. Now we need the ammeter to measure the inductor current. Therefore, take this ammeter block from here and bring it in the model. Connect it with the inductor as shown here. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that now we need to connect the switching device such as transistor. Therefore, come to model again. Take this MOSFET block from here and bring it in the model. Rotate it by pressing Ctrl plus R. Now right click on this block, click on rotate and flip. Then click on flip block and then click on right left. Now connect the one terminal of the ammeter with the MOSFET block as shown here. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that now we need to connect the diode. Therefore, come to model again. Take this diode block from here and bring it in the model. Double click on this diode block and uncheck this show measurement port and press OK. Connect one terminal of the diode with the circuit as shown here. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that now we need to connect the capacitor. Therefore, come to model again. Copy this inductor block and paste it here. Rotate it by pressing Ctrl plus R. Connect positive terminal with the diode terminal as shown here. As we need capacitor, therefore double click on this block. In the branch type, select capacitor and press OK. We know that according to data, the value for capacitor is 400 microfarad. Therefore, come to model and put here 400 microfarad value and press OK. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that now we need to connect to the resistor or load. Therefore, come to model again. Copy this capacitor block and paste it here. Connect positive terminal with the circuit as shown here. As we need resistor, therefore double click on this block. In the branch type, select resistor and press OK. We know that according to data, the value for capacitor is 4 ohm. Therefore, come to model and put here 4 ohm value and press OK. Now connect the negative terminals with the negative terminals of the DC voltage source to complete the circuit as shown here. Now we need the voltmeter to measure the output voltage. Therefore, take this voltmeter block from here and bring it in the model. Connect it across the resistor as shown here. Now we need the scope to measure the output voltage and current. Therefore, take this scope block from here and bring it in the model. Connect it with the inductor port first. Now copy the scope block, paste it here and connect it with the voltmeter port. Now we need pulse generator block. For this purpose, write this pulse generator in the search and press enter. Take this pulse generator block from here and bring it in the model. Connect it with the gate signal of the MOSFET block. Double click on this block. We have to put the value for time period. To get this value, we know that according to data, it has switching frequency of 25 kHz. Due to this, its time period will be equal to 40 microseconds as calculated here. Therefore, come to model and put here 40 microseconds value. Now, we have to put the percentage value of the pulse width. To get this value, we know that according to data, the duty cycle is given as 0.4. The pulse width is equal to the percentage of the duty cycle. Due to this, its percentage will be equal to 40% as shown here. Therefore, come to model and put here 40% value and press OK. At this stage, our model is completed. Now we can run the simulation. Set the simulation time to 2 seconds. Furthermore, we also need the power GUI block to run the simulation. Therefore, take the power GUI block from here and bring it in the model. Now run the simulation by clicking on this play button. Now double click on this scope to see the output voltage. You can see it provides the maximum voltage of 18.83, whereas we need the output voltage of 20 volt. Furthermore, it may have ripple voltage of 0.2 volt, whereas in our simulation it has ripple voltage of 0.188 volt. Similarly, double click on this scope to see the inductor current. You can see it provides the maximum current of 7.79 ampere, whereas we need the inductor current of 8.33 ampere. Furthermore, it may have ripple current of 2.5 ampere, whereas in our simulation it has ripple current of 2.35 ampere. Friends, you may wonder why our results are not accurate. The main reason for this is due to the fact that we have designed boost converter as open loop. In open loop mode, we need the manual tuning of the duty cycle of the pulse generator. Therefore, we have to try it again and again to get the accurate result. Another method to get the accurate results is to use the closed loop boost converter. In the closed loop system, it is possible to get the output extremely close to the desired output voltage. Friends, this closed loop boost converter system is very important topic for the research. Many optimization techniques as well as intelligent techniques can be used on this topic to complete your bachelor degree FYP project, master degree research, or one of the PhD research objectives. Therefore, I have decided to make many videos on this closed loop boost converter with various intelligent controllers in order to help you. Therefore, don't miss my future videos on this series. Friends, for your convenience, I have uploaded this boost converter model in the form of link in the description section of this video. For this purpose, go to the description section of this video. You can see the link is available here. You just need to copy this link from the description, paste it in the Google and press enter, or simply click on this link. This new window will be opened which contains the boost converter model. Now click on this button to download this folder. Now click on start download. You can see it has downloaded the folder. Now click on open folder to see the location of this folder. Now right click on it and click on cut. And bring it in any drive or folder where you want to place it. Or create new folder. Give it any name of your choice. And paste it here. Now right click on this folder and click on extract. You can see it has extracted the folder. Double click on this folder to open it. You can see it contains the PDF file as well as the Simulink model of the boost converter. Now to open it in MATLAB software correctly, go to MATLAB software's screen. Go to E drive or where you have saved this folder in order to bring this folder in the MATLAB as shown here. You can see boost converter model folder is available here. Now double click on it. You can see simulink model of the boost converter is available here. Double click on this model to open it in Simulink. Wait for few seconds. You can see Simulink has opened this model correctly. Now you can run the simulation as discussed in this video. You can see it is working fine. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel, and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.